Hi, I'm Mike.
And I'm Chris. Today we're going to have a quick look at how this keypad works and how to hook it up to an Arduino. These are the two most common keypads. They are cheap and easy to use. This one has 12 buttons, while this one offers 16 buttons. The first kind requires 7 pins from the Arduino, while the bigger one requires just one more, 8 pins. Let's explore the insides of the biggest one.
The keypad is divided into 4 rows and 4 columns. When no buttons are pressed, there are no connections between the columns and the rows. When you press a button, you connect one row to one column. We can then start to figure out which button you just pressed. One way to determine this is by outputting a high signal to one of the rows at a time. Then, we measure the columns. If column 1 is high, when we power row 1, we know that button 1 is being pressed. If we instead press button 5, there are no connections between row 1 and either of the columns. We then know that no buttons in the first row are being pressed. Then, we stop the power to the first row and power up the second row instead. Now, there's a connection between row 2 and column 2. Then we know that button 5 is pressed. In this manner, we can loop through all the rows and columns to see which buttons are being pressed.
Luckily, we don't have to keep track of this, as we can just use an Arduino. Open up your Arduino IDE. Go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries, and search for Keypad. Select Keypad by Mark and Alexander and click Install. Then, go to File, Examples, Keypad, and open Hello Keypad. Since we are using a 4x4 keypad, also set calls equals 4. Then, add the values of the last column, A, B, C, and D. We are going to connect the keypad to an Arduino Nano, so we also need to change the pins and add pin number 9. You can find a link to this script in the description. Upload the code to your Arduino and open the serial window. Make sure you have selected the right baud rates. Then, when you push a button, it will now appear on the screen.
If you found this video helpful, please leave a like.
And remember to subscribe.
See you later!